기억이 좀 안 나요.
Oh, hey, how you doing? Let me finish this up right here. Take us off. Let's go into that. As always, you know who I am and you know what I do. So, we're going to do a little bit of this. Today, we're going to talk about the U.S.-led bombing in Syria, looking for ISIS, ISIL. We're going to call it, I call it ISIS, and I always will. Today, ISIS is being bombed. Like, the U.S. is conducting campaigns, and this is through a coalition. Now the Brits just hopped on board. By the time you've seen this video, Britain has just hopped on board the U.K. of the coalition. France is in there, and the Arab states, which I'll talk about probably another video. But they're jumping in here because they're going after ISIS, and they're going after that there's another quote-unquote JV team of ISIS. I'll talk about them later. But what this is, they're going after, since Assad can't control them, and since ISIS is hiding in Syria, we're in ISIS. We're bombing Syria. The president decided, you know, and that's his quote, no boots on the ground, which I never understand that one. There are going to have to be some sort of boots on the ground in Syria to dig out ISIS, but that's another factor for another day. But we're supposedly in Syria to bomb ISIS, to get rid of all the militant ISIS terrorists. And if you don't know by now, let me up your speed. ISIS stands for the Islamic State of Israel and Syria. Now, and their goal is to have Iraq and Syria into one big country, which is a bigger goal, and have a big, back in the day, I forget what the land was used to be called, but they want to control this big Syria, Iraq, landmass, and form to one. Now, the United States is against that because ISIS is so-called, they say they're savage, but who isn't nowadays? ISIS has allegedly beheaded a lot of Westerners, which for the love of God, I understand. A lot of you Westerners, and I'm a Westerner, so why would you go to a place where you know if you get caught? No, it's one thing if you're with a battalion or if it's a war, you're entrenched with them. Why would you go off on your own knowing that this could happen to you? It's the naivety, that's how I want to say, the naivety of the Western world thinking that you can go anywhere. Well, you can't do that. It's not like if you're from France, you can come visit America and you can go anywhere. You can do that. You can't do that over there. There's certain things you have to do, certain passes you have to get. And a lot, I mean, it's just, I don't know. It's like when the young kids, I don't know what I'm talking about. It's like when the guy who just got 6 years in North Korea, he got 6 years flat. He's an American. But like I said, people think when they leave the Western world, hey, I'm from America, I'm from Britain, I'm from France. They're like, big deal, you're in our country now, it's our rules. And that's another topic for another day. Today we're talking about ISIS and ISIL. Now, I'm going to talk about another video about the Arab Coalition, but I think I'll get into it in this one. Because the Arab Coalition has joined. So the Arab Coalition is Saudi Arabia, the United Arab Emirates, Qatar, Jordan, and I think there's another one, I'm not sure. Now, this is what's strange about it. Saudi Arabia and Qatar have funded ISIS. Because, I made another video, but I'll talk about it again here too. ISIS is the remnants of the Saddam Hussein Ba'athist Party empire. They're mostly Ba'athist soldiers, generals that were like the top leader, and Saddam Hussein was Ba'athist. They were in the top, and like I said, most of them fled to Syria anyway because Assad gave them credit for and gave them his approval to hide there. And so, and all of a sudden, but think of it this way. We gave the United States, gave 60 million to Syrian rebels to fight Assad. all of a sudden, these guys pop up. I mean, is it rocket science? I don't know. But, and like I said, back to my point, Syria and Qatar was funding ISIS. Because you know why? ISIS was against the regime that Iraq has now. And the regime that Iraq has now is not, they're Shiites. So Iran was backing the regime that Iran used to have when al-Maliki was in power, but al-Maliki wasn't having the backing of the Qataris and the Saudis. See, the Saudis' plan is, and the Qataris, use us as what they're doing, use us as the puppet or as the engine to drive everything. We do this, we do their dirty work. The Saudis, you divide Iraq into three places. You divide Iraq into a Eastern Iraq, which might be assimilated into Iran. You give the Kurds their northern area, and you give like a western southern part to Syria, and blend it all into Syria, which the Saudis will take over. But don't forget what we're talking about. You're dealing with a lot of oil in this situation. If you notice, the Saudis and Qataris are very proactive here. There's oil to be dealt with. There's money to be made. And the Qataris and the Saudis do not want us to have a hand up. Because, like I said, Danielson can't beat Mr. Miyagi. And the Saudis to us are Mr. Miyagi because they're paying for us to do all this. But as far as our bombing them, it took a PR. It's a PR stunt because Congress was wanting, the people were wanting, and if they were real terrorists, you would have got them ahead of time. You would have warned them. You would say, hey, look, you act up, we're coming. You wouldn't have gave them a warning because right now they're entrenched and we're hitting bunkers and we're getting them. But now we got this phenomenon that is they're so good that they're getting people from the Western world to join them. And I don't mean the reporters that they capture. I mean they're getting like young people from the Western world to come here. Come there and join them. And this is another phenomenon which is crazy. Like, and I think I have an understanding of why these people are doing it. I think what it is, because here in America, a lot of these young people don't have nothing to look up to, because ever since our moral decline here in America, we don't fight for nothing. We like say gay rights, anybody can do what they want to do, there's no morality. ISIS is at least standing up fighting for something, and it gives people a sense of, it's like I tell you in all of the other videos, people want to be led. And if you're a good leader, and if you have good leadership skills, and if you have a group of leaders that are good, people will follow that. I think what ISIS gives them a sense of that. And they're like, they're enamored with it, so they run off to the Middle East and go fight with them. I mean, me, I wouldn't do that. I mean, I have a discussion with them, and I have had discussions with them. Through my, don't think that they're not on the social media, because they are on social media. I've had discussions with them, and I talked to them, Nothing serious. I just wanted to know what their end game was. I have no problem talking. I'll talk to Hamas. I'll talk to Hezbollah. I have no problem talking because I want to know what the end game is in the end for that whole scenario, which I kind of know with Hezbollah and Hamas, but I want to have a dialogue with that. But back to ISIS. ISIS is when they took over a lot of land in Iran. But when I got to the Kurds kind of buffered it, and they kind of not really messing with the Kurds, because at the end of the proverbial day, Turkey backs the Kurds, whether they like it or not. Turkey will step in if the Kurds, because the only reason Turkey stepping in to help the Kurds, because after the Kurds comes Turkey. So, and besides, Turkey's a NATO partner, better for less. Worse or for poor. And what's that called? Better or for worse? There you go. That's the quote I'm looking for. But as ISIS goes, this Arab coalition is one of the, which is a new phenomenon. There hasn't been an Arab coalition like this since whenever we kicked Iraq out of Kuwait. And of course, they had to do that because they were afraid once they ran through Kuwait, they're going to run through Qatar. The Saudis were a little scared because Iran was kicking ass then. But as far as the Arab coalition, but the only problem with the Arab coalition is the United States has made overtures to Iran to kind of back us up as far as endorse us looking for terrorism, and the Iranian head, either the Iranian president or the Ayatollah, he said that it was a kind of a sucker. Basically, he said it was a bad deal because these guys are savages and they're entrenched, and all we're going to do is rally the other ones to, you know, rally behind them, the cause, which I think is correct, because every time we're over there, look what happens. We were supposed to be done in the Middle East. We're not. If Iraq would have took that security agreement, probably some of this would never be happening. So at the end of the day, folks, don't be a terrorist. All right? Peace.
Great guy. He told me so himself.